contest is a special attraction match set for one fall.
One fall!
Please welcome to the ring.
You see Brett Yehi coming out here solo. Earlier tonight, we saw him leave the ring, abandon his Catch Point members because of their association with Stokely Hathaway. You think there's going to be any ramifications because of it?
You bring up a great point there, Tim. We're going to see. We're also going to see Fred Yehi by himself, not part of Catch Point, and against Kyle O'Reilly. We'll talk a bit about Kyle O'Reilly and who this young man is. For those of you not familiar here, on FlowSlam.tv. Who has held championships and defended those championships literally all over the world. We hadn't seen him here in Evolve Wrestling since Evolve 6 in 2010. Man, the Kyle O'Reilly that returned last night at Evolve 82 and who defeated Keith Lee in a match that I dare say stole the show. Man, there's no question. This is a star. This is a man who immediately has jumped to the top of the rankings here in Evolve, physical or metaphysical, however you want to put it. Heck of a talent, but I'm going to be honest with you. When I watched the way that Kyle O'Reilly came in with those strikes and how he went from different appendages to different appendages, it was a little non-traditional. Well, guess what? That is Fred Yehi's M.O. This was a matchup. This is a matchup I was absolutely excited to see how these two would pair off. And O'Reilly is not fazed by that. He's in big trouble. War cry, if you will, from Fred Yehi.
No, Kyle O'Reilly not intimidated whatsoever, especially after coming off that huge victory last night at Evolve 82.
Takes him down, though. It does Fred Yehi. So he was already going potentially for a pin.
Yeah, both of these athletes going to try and feel each other out here at the start of this matchup.
You saw O'Reilly was about to put that body scissors on, and Yehi able to push those legs out with his strength, and instead now going in almost like a stretch muffler, but instead caught into the ropes, and the ropes saving him from what could have become that Armageddon we talked about last night that Kyle O'Reilly's known to use. These two men get ready to face off. This is a matchup that once upon a time I could have never even imagined happening. It's so exciting to see Fred Yehi and Kyle O'Reilly here in an Evolve Wrestling ring.
Yeah, coming in here tonight, probably one of the more highly anticipated matchups here on the Evolve 83 card. Everyone was talking about this. I was outside in the parking lot before the show started. Fans and discussion. Everyone was excited to see Kyle O'Reilly face off against Fred Yehi.
Right now, Matt Wrestling, and in control is Kyle O'Reilly, but so quickly, you can see Fred Yehi, in fact, he just did, countering things. These are two men who I would dare say when it comes to the Matt ability, maybe well matched, but the submission style and skills of a Kyle O'Reilly. If I'm Fred Yehi, I'm gonna have to be extra careful. I mean, we may be talking the difference between, like, this is on one of those, like, 100 score levels, the difference between a guy in his high 90s and his low 90s when it comes to some of those skill sets. But regardless,
Yeah, it's not only, though, you mentioned Kyle O'Reilly's extensive knowledge of submission maneuvers, but last night we got to see his amazing strength on display as well. So it's not only submission maneuvers that Freddie Ehi has to concern himself with, it could be some very powerful maneuvers on top of it.
Yeah, again, taking him down, going for the headlock. Into the pitfall, not enough to even hold him down for one, though. However, it's a great way to force the man to let go of the headlock. Yehi will not let go, though. And as he continues to work and hold on, I'll tell you right now, you feel your head start to just crunch in together. While Fred's able to not only perhaps gain some breath back, but think about what's next. However, O'Reilly able to fight his way out. And Fred, though, bouncing off the second rope. So unique the way he comes out. You see that tackle taking down O'Reilly. And the stop. I was waiting for it there. And on the hand, by the way. Now, this is going to be interesting to see. Did O'Reilly scout Freddie Ehi and those stomps he's so known for? As he begins that submission here. Submission predicament, putting all of his weight on the legs. And that hurts, not just on the legs where he's got him, but you see how his feet are under him as well?
Absolutely, applying all of that body weight, so much pressure. But as you can see, as Freddie Ehi is trying to execute that submission maneuver, leaving his body wide open for a counter.
And you notice he's able to continue to hold on to the arm like that. I mean, this is one of those, or like, should I say, this is one of those situations as Ehi uses the elbow and continues to work on the leg. Both of these men with so many submissions in their wrestling vocabulary, you never know where's going to come, what's going to come. And in fact, right here, if he sits back on this, this is not going to be good for Kyle O'Reilly. Stopping down instead, and that knee. I'll see O'Reilly throwing as many kicks if he can't stand up.
No, absolutely not.
And you see the defensive position trying to get out, and Ehi just staying on him. And in fact, exploder suplex.
You see Kyle O'Reilly still holding on to that knee, still feeling the effect of it.
Well, you know, if I'm a Freddie Ehi, this is a guy, and we talked about this situation with Catchpoint and him leaving. You know, he found his way in Catchpoint through battles with guys like Drew Gulak, and it really culminated last year at the WWE Live Experience 2016. And then Yehi's went on to become the full Impact Pro heavyweight champion of the world, which, by the way, he still holds to this day. Had been an Evolve Tag Team Champion until last night. And it's a guy we've seen really travel all over the country making a name, but he hasn't made his name to the level yet that Kyle O'Reilly has. A victory over O'Reilly tonight could be the thing that further puts Fred on the map. Not that he's not already, as he's just twisting the body of O'Reilly into a pretzel and just the way he's holding the leg down. I don't think O'Reilly expected this.
No, Trevin, we are sitting here ringside. We could actually be witnessing a technical masterpiece, that type of action you can only find in Evolve. Two incredible athletes showing their best here tonight in Brooklyn, New York.
And as he continues to work on that knee here, O'Reilly can't even get to his feet. What a chop. Chest of O'Reilly already red. It's going to get a lot redder if Ehi continues. Trying to roll him out, throws him in the corner. He had to assist him getting across with that knee so bad. And another chop again. The wind, the air out of O'Reilly's lungs just being knocked out. In fact, able to get out of the way again is Ehi.
Trying to attempt that reversal there, but unsuccessful. Another cover.
But emphatic kick out right there. I mean, that lateral press didn't even hold him down for exactly two.
No. And Freddie Ehi, he's got to hook the leg. Yeah, Kyle O'Reilly is an incredible athlete. You can't just lay over him and expect to secure that three count.
No, and I also think it says something about O'Reilly. Despite the apparent trouble he's in right now, he could have stayed down to catch his breath. No, he's making sure he's kicking out. He's showing you, I've got life, but I don't know how long he's going to have life after that running forearm. He was going for that spinning discus, but instead now strikes from O'Reilly, who then sweeps the leg. But look at him stagger, Tim.
Yeah, absolutely. It is hard for him to put any weight on that leg. That knee in a lot of pain. He keeps grabbing it.
O'Reilly, though, now somehow getting some life back into that knee. able to get some kicks in there, starting to take control with those strikes there to the midsection of the chest of Yehi, and that mixed martial arts type offense from O'Reilly, so effective, as now the body scissors applied.
But you gotta wonder, how much strength does Kyle O'Reilly really have in those legs right now?
I don't know, but those forearms to the back of the neck are definitely assisting things. And even if he doesn't quite have it all the way on him here, trying to pull the arms of Fred Yehi behind him. You see Fred fighting with all strength and pushing the pin back, forcing O'Reilly to fight his way back. Man, going, looking for that arm bar.
Trying to secure it, but it's Fred Yehi closing up to the ropes. Wraps his feet around him.
If Kyle O'Reilly gets the Armageddon, and as he calls it, this match would be over. Now those kicks to the sternum. Amazing Yehi, though, able to get to his feet. However, perhaps assisted by Kyle O'Reilly as he continues the attack.
Trying to soften up that arm.
Now the proverbial pendulum swinging, it seems. Yehi trying to fight his way out, but O'Reilly not being fazed. And in fact, twisting the arm and bringing Yehi face first onto the mat.
Yeah, forcefully planting him there. Kyle O'Reilly, though, maybe wasting a little too much time here. He's got to stay on top of Fred Yehi.
You got to think right now, O'Reilly, ooh, almost the stop. Couldn't tell if he was going for the knee, but Yehi definitely trying to fight his way back. That kick right there might have caught Yehi bad.
Yeah, it looked like his face hit hard off the mat there.
No, there's a reason you throw strikes at someone, but usually they're attempting to block, defend themselves. There was no defense there by Yehi, who's now caught, can't defend himself again as he gets his ribs punched and elbowed by O'Reilly. And as he snapmares him out, going again for that arm.
And trying to soften it up so he can secure that arm bar that he attempted just moments ago.
I'll tell you right now, when it comes to Kyle O'Reilly and what we saw last night against Keith Lee, what a battle, what a matchup. And we're starting to see some of that offense and things that were so effective last night getting into play here. Yehi had things early on, trying to fight out again and perhaps becoming successful now with those forearms.
Laying him in hard.
But look, tackling him down as O'Reilly as he just mat wrestles him down. And now those strikes, those palm strikes to Yehi. Yehi barely able to defend himself.
And trying to secure that arm bar once again.
Yeah, Armageddon, it is over as Yehi gets to the bottom rope there, breaking in. That great move and ring presence by Fred Yehi.
Yeah, the rope saving him once again. Kyle O'Reilly focusing on that arm, trying to soften it up so he can get that arm bar locked in.
And will we start to see the type of offense we saw from O'Reilly last night, who runs in with that forearm? If he gets started, Tim, this match complexion will definitely change. Well, that was interesting as he sat him out and put him right there into that leg lock. That was different.
Yeah, but did you notice first he focused on the arm? Focused on the arm and then went to the leg.
And look at the counter from Yehi. Both men holding on to the leg. This becomes one of those
battle of wills here.
Great point. Can you handle it? How much can you take? Is now Yehi kicking in and trying to wrench it in. Both of these men are really exposing themselves right now from the point of view of you really can't defend this. You can only both use offense at the same time. And now O'Reilly forced to roll through and make it to the sanctuary of the bottom rope.
Incredible veteran knowledge right there by Kyle O'Reilly, rolling through, no longer trying to battle it out. We've already seen Fred Yehi work on that leg extensively throughout this contest.
And Kyle O'Reilly showing the effects. However, Yehi showing the effects of that offense, and he's grabbed on the leg. O'Reilly now forearms to break free. My goodness, what a forearm from Yehi himself in that chop. Those chops all night have been brutal.
But O'Reilly returning the favor.
Looks like O'Reilly's starting to get the better of him, too.
Coming off the ropes, looking for that kick. Yehi with the reversal, stomp on the foot.
Indeed, the stomp followed by the forearm. But stopping the spinning forearm, great move by Kyle O'Reilly. However, that chop block there, taking him down.
Right to that same knee, figure four leg lock.
Textbook figure four here, Kyle O'Reilly in the center of the ring. He's got three choices right now, Tim. He can tap out, which he sure as heck knows he doesn't want to do. He can pass out. I'm about to give you a fourth choice. I screwed this up. He can try to roll it over, which is incredibly hard and dangerous to do because you can make yourself into a worse position, or he can make it to the ropes. And you can see Fred doing everything he can to stop him from rolling through, but instead, O'Reilly able to get just enough momentum to do it.
Great ring awareness there by both competitors all throughout this contest. You've seen Fred Yehi use those ropes to break up maneuvers multiple times. Now Kyle O'Reilly doing the same thing. O'Reilly trying to hold on to those ropes.
What a stomp to the knee. Yehi so effective in that offense and catching him. And that release, German, folds up Kyle O'Reilly. This could be a Tim.
Two.
And O'Reilly kicks out.
We saw those German suplexes last night when Fred Yehi, I believe it was four German suplexes that he planted Larry Dallas with.
And I'm not sure where O'Reilly was able to dig down in to kick out, but you cannot question the tenacity of a Kyle O'Reilly, nor can you question the reaction we're hearing here for Fred Yehi from the WWN faithful. Now we're getting some O'Reilly chants back. Great elbows back from Yehi. In some ways, Yehi definitely has a home field advantage when it comes to just being, you know, such a WWN regular in general, whereas Kyle O'Reilly returning. And right now here.
Oh, very smart move right there by Kyle O'Reilly, faking out, going for the head, catches him in the midsection.
Absolutely, going for a stomp of his own, but instead, looked like Yehi was going to roll him up, but able to catch the counter of O'Reilly, catch the leg again.
And again, going right back to that leg and knee.
Corkscrewing that knee. I mean, you got to think at some point here, too, O'Reilly just may have no choice. He may not be able to walk. As Yehi ducks the kick and nukes the knee, that basement dropkick Yehi's known for.
It is nothing short of impressive that Kyle O'Reilly's even able to stand at this point.
Fred definitely has made his target clear. Yehi chants breaking out here in Brooklyn, New York. But the O'Reilly chants starting to come in as well. A little bit of decisiveness here from the WWN faithful. And Fred trying to power him up. But somehow O'Reilly, not even, oh wait, go to the armbar. However, Yehi going for the pin to defend himself, and that was incredibly smart, forcing O'Reilly to break the arm again. And look, O'Reilly can't even get across the
ring.
And
that's what I was talking about.
And the stop again, and this time going after the heel as well as the knee. And a unique way to grab onto that head here while still holding onto the knee with his foot.
It was just a matter of time, Trevin. I had just said it moments ago. I was impressed that Kyle O'Reilly was able to get up. It was just a matter of time before he was no longer able to apply weight to that knee.
And that fisherman into the bomb. Kyle O'Reilly again kicks out.
Incredible heart on display by Kyle O'Reilly, kicking out once again just in the nick of time.
Yehi, though, continuing the attack here, going to four pinfalls. He's looking to put all his weight on him, but wait, rolling him through. This is a unique series of kicks to the chest and sternum here.
You see Fred Yehi, hands locked in, keeping Kyle O'Reilly in place.
Can't get away. And if he does, he's forced to put weight on that knee, which really doesn't have the strength to do as he gets chopped again by Yehi. But somehow just enough energy in there to get that running knee, and you can see he just can't walk across the ring right now.
Absolutely not. But again, trying to soften up that arm, but Fred Yehi with a quick reversal.
And go for the sleeper. However, that Saito suplex dumping Yehi on his head. And O'Reilly now, does he have enough left in the tank to really start to even make much of an offensive? Was that instinct there?
I mean, it's an opportune time for Kyle O'Reilly to take advantage, but when you can barely move.
And a two count only there. Kudos to Yehi for having the energy to kick out. Definitely showing the effects of them smash up, as are both men. I mean, these two guys have thrown just about everything at each other, both from a mat wrestling and a submission point of view. But Yehi right now prone. O'Reilly trying to get him up and over, but Yehi again fighting back, using the elbows to stop him. Both men getting the chance here from the above faithful. Series of strikes from O'Reilly now. That shining wizard, and now we're starting to see the Kyle O'Reilly we saw last night who defeated Keith Lee.
Absolutely, and did you notice there, he did not use that left leg to apply that shining wizard. He had to move to the right leg. so much pain and agony that he's suffering through right now on that left leg.
And I'm sure neither man's thinking about tomorrow or even 5 minutes from now unless the match is continuing. But point being, what's going to be the long-term effects of a match like this on either guy, let alone the knee of a Kyle O'Reilly?
Well, great thing Evolve 84 isn't tomorrow. I mean, after coming off of all the action last night, it's amazing these guys are battling it out once again at Evolve 83 just 24 hours after Saturday night.
And you can see here, wrenching it in is Kyle O'Reilly. Yehi forced down to a knee here. Referee staying in, watching both men closely. If he thinks these men don't have the ability to defend themselves, he can stop this matchup. And with a kick like that, followed by that spinning forearm, calls that the axe and smash, was successful, but not for long as he gets nuked again by Fred Yehi.
These guys are leaving it all in the ring tonight. Yes, it is the referee's discretion. He could stop the match, but I'm telling you right now, neither of these athletes would want that to happen.
Okay, look at Kyle just holding on to his knee here. Yehi holding on to his chest, his gut, his ribs, trying to come to life, get the energy to stand up. His arms in pain. I mean, every inch of these men's body has to hurt right now.
Oh, absolutely. And the crowd behind both competitors.
O'Reilly the first one to strike, but Yehi able to go right back after the knee there. Over O'Reilly, you see, going after the arm, which throughout this match he's been attacking. And of course, Yehi going after the knee.
Look at that, so focused, both men. Yehi still going after the knee. Kyle O'Reilly going after the arm. Back and forth they go.
Wants to budge, but their bodies are starting to give out. Adrenaline can only take you so far. But listen to the sign of respect here from Brooklyn, New York. And both men punch each other at the same time, and those palm strikes at the same time. They are down. And this is one of those times where they've got that 10 count to answer. One of the men has to get to his feet. Unless ropes get involved, I mean, this could be the way it ends, Tim.
This could go all night. I mean, and you hear the crowd here in Brooklyn, New York, absolutely showing their appreciation of both men battling it out, leaving it all in the ring.
Will they be able to answer the 10 count once again? You can see signs of life for sure, but I mentioned this. Oh, wait, he kips up. You see him crumpling down with Yehi. Perhaps expecting a little too much, I would start to bring up the point of mind over matter, and eventually your mind can only make your body do so much. But Yehi now, going for the full Nelson, however countered by Kyle O'Reilly, who's so quick to go to the armbar. And if he is successful here,
trying to lock it in.
And that would be it. Yehi, you can see, going for those knees. He's trying to force O'Reilly to let go, but O'Reilly refuses.
Hard knee strikes to that temple area.
And I mean, at some point, he's got no choice. In fact, a brainbuster. We saw it last night.
This put Keithley away. Oh, no.
Not enough. But go for the armbar. The Armageddon. Yehi's in trouble. He is in the center of the ring, holding on for dear life, trying to not let that arm free.
But you can see the fingers just slipping away from one another as Yehi trying to hold on desperately, not allowing Kyle O'Reilly to lock in that armbar. It's locked in, and there's the bell. Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, we told you, Kyle O'Reilly coming back to Evolve Wrestling. There's no question, this is a main event star. Anywhere he goes in the world, and he has proved it in his return to Evolve Wrestling with a victory over Keith Lee at Evolve 82 and Fred Yehi tonight at Evolve 83.
Incredible, a standing ovation for both men here in Brooklyn, New York. Trevin, I'm gonna say it. When the dream of Evolve first began, I'm pretty sure it is matches like that that they expected to set the standard. That was absolutely amazing.
These were two great athletes. Facing off here. Sign of respect.
And the applause continues. There's nobody sitting down. Incredible ovation for Fred Yehi and Kyle O'Reilly.
Once again, welcome back to Evolve Wrestling, Kyle O'Reilly and Fred Yehi. He's shown he does not need to be a part of Catchpoint to be one of the best pound for pound Catch Ken professional wrestlers anywhere in the world. And Tim, I'm going to be completely and utterly honest. I truly hope we see a rematch between these two athletes in the future here in the World Wrestling Network.
Absolutely. And if I'm not sitting in this commentary booth, I'll buy a ticket to see that.
As you can see here, O'Reilly is literally having to crawl up the stairs. He can barely walk.